did Topher Grace manage to land the role of Eric Foreman without having an audition? Was his departure from That 70s Show the result of a major feud behind the scenes? And will we get to see the show's cast back together for a reunion? Hi, I'm Janet. You're watching ASA, and we're heading back to the 70s. An acting debut more surprising than his exit. Did you know that Topher Grace actually never expected to land the role of Eric Foreman? In fact, he didn't even audition for the part. Instead, he managed to join the cast in the most unexpected way. It all started when he had to quit his high school tennis team after spraining his ankle. As consolation, Topher joined the cast of the school play, despite having no previous experience in drama. And just like some kind of rom-com, he was spotted by a pair of Hollywood bigwigs. As the actor recalled, "I was at a boarding school in New Hampshire, and this girl who did the sets, her parents were big-time Hollywood producers and produced That 70s Show and Third Rock from the Sun. For anyone wondering, her parents were Bonnie and Terry Turner." The following year, when Topher was in L.A. studying at university, the Turners actually called him to offer him a role in an upcoming sitcom. The only problem was that he had no idea how Hollywood auditions worked, as he'd never done one. He later explained, "They said, bring a headshot and a resume. So I brought it, and it was this terrible resume of jobs I did at the mall, and the picture was me and my friends at Six Flags." Amazingly, even with his embarrassing headshot and a total lack of experience, Topher got the part. And with such an easy time getting the role, it's not surprising that Topher felt as though he had not truly earned his success on the show. As he explained in an interview, "I was honestly lucky to get on That 70s Show. I've always felt guilty about that. I was a guy who hadn't worked before, and so many others have dedicated years to get where I managed to end up." Because of the huge success of That 70s Show, fans were genuinely shocked when Topher Grace announced that he would be leaving the show and the role of Eric Foreman. Surprisingly, it wasn't his guilt that made him leave. There were also major scheduling conflicts. From the silver screen to the big screen. That 70s Show wasn't just Topher Grace's first role. It was his first exposure to acting in general, and he was hooked. The actor later admitted that his time spent on the show inspired him to try to work with some of his favorite directors and the biggest names in the business. But to do that, he needed to bulk up his resume and get some more acting jobs. Initially, Topher tried working on other projects while still filming That 70s Show. In 2000, he landed a small part in the film Traffic, which he followed up with three more films in 2004, including Win a Date with Tad Hamilton, In Good Company, and P.S. Topher's film career was really taking off. However, he soon learned that it was too challenging to work on a film career while still shooting That 70s Show. And by the end of the show's seventh season in 2007, Topher realized that the only way he could really break out into film was if he said goodbye to playing Eric Foreman. So that's what he did. Thankfully, his leap of faith into the complicated world of feature films was rewarded when he landed the role of Venom in Sam Raimi's Spider-Man 3. Despite the movie not being a fan favorite, it did draw attention to the fact that Topher could do more than play a sassy teen from the 70s, and this was really important for the actor, who did not want to be typecast. In a 2018 interview, Topher elaborated, "I guess I feel like it's a duty based on the good fortune of the show, not to just cash in on the same role over and over again. I need to try something different every time." Not just that, but he admitted that he wanted to earn his success through working on a variety of different and challenging projects, and not just limiting himself to a single role or show. But that didn't mean he wasn't grateful for the opportunities That 70s Show afforded him. In fact, Topher has often explained that through the show, he earned enough money and recognition to be really picky about future roles. He didn't have to work in Hollywood, he just really wanted to. In thanks, he agreed to return for the series finale in order to give himself and fans closure and properly say farewell to Eric Foreman. When misunderstanding leads to mayhem. Despite the actor explaining that he left That 70s Show to pursue a film career, not everyone was convinced that this was the only reason for his departure. In fact, immediately after he left the show, rumors started surfacing that Topher left because of major beef behind the scenes. And to be honest, we can kind of see why. Initially, fans were worried he'd done something naughty behind the scenes and was being fired because The 70s Show's writers considered recasting the role of Eric or writing him out of the show completely. This may seem a bit drastic, but remember that Ashton Kutcher, who played Michael Kelso, had also just left the show, and as a result, the ratings were suffering. Thankfully, they decided against writing Eric out of the show totally and instead introduced a new character called Randy, who was played by Josh Myers. But it gets worse. Josh was also expected to play a love interest for Laura Prepron's character, Donna. And this was when a second rumor about Topher was leaked, which was way more damaging to the actor's ego. According to Laura, Topher was a terrible kisser. In fact, this was actually backed up by Joseph Gordon-Levitt, who had a small role on That 70s Show as Eric's gay friend. After a scene in which the two locked lips, Joseph apparently admitted that Topher was the worst kisser he'd encountered in his entire career. Talk about a burn! The final event which convinced fans of a feud between the show's cast was Topher's failure to appear in Ashton Kutcher's new reality show, Punk'd. This made him the only former cast member not to appear on the reality show, which made fans a little suspicious of the relationship between the two actors. When Topher also didn't attend Ashton Kutcher's wedding to Mila Kunis, it seemed that there really may have been something going on between the cast. Despite this evidence, Topher and the rest of the cast have been adamant that there were no hard feelings between them. In fact, he has admitted that he's still great friends with everyone and frequently praises his co-stars, including Ashton and Mila. So why wasn't he at their wedding? It's simple. He was busy working in Australia.
I mean, I know both the bride and the groom in that situation. They are both amazing people. So the fact that they're together and they have a kid is like, it's like your two great friends from high school got together after high school.
So there you have it. There was never any feud, just a whole lot of love. Was the switch to a film career worth it? While Spider-Man may not have been the most impressive acting credit on his resume, Topher has since gone on to try out several different roles and genres. From the rom-com Valentine's Day in 2010, in which he played alongside some pretty big names like Jennifer Garner and Julia Roberts. The same year, he was also on the cast of Predator, giving him a chance to play a dramatic action role. He followed this up with a few mostly minor parts in smaller films, before branching out into more high-profile roles in Interstellar in 2014 and War Machine in 2017, alongside Brad Pitt. Since then, he's appeared in Black Klansman and Love, Death, and Robots. Although it may not seem that Topher's film career has truly taken off, he is perfectly content with his career. In fact, he's even trying his hand at a new medium, podcasts. Since 2020, when Topher and his wife Ashley welcomed their second child, he's traded the screen for the mic and is the host of a podcast called Minor Adventures with Topher Grace. And he's surprisingly humble about this new change, telling HuffPost that he enjoys it because it's so different to his previous jobs. He explained, "What I've actually learned while doing these episodes is that it doesn't matter if I'm actually not good at any of it or this podcast. I'm actually bad at a lot of them, actually, but it's fun either way." And even with all of his new challenges and parts, Topher is still grateful to the show that started it all. When asked if he minds people still associating him with Eric, the actor admitted that he loves it. He elaborated, "Oh yeah, we spent a lot of time doing that show, and we all loved it, and the people loved it. I still love it. I love the character. I love all those kids." But does he love them enough to work with them again? Despite sharing the screen with Ashton Kutcher in 2010's Valentine's Day, Topher hasn't teamed up with any of the gang since leaving the show, and that's a hard pill for fans to swallow. So we can't help but wonder if there's any chance of seeing Topher and the rest of the gang together again. And we're not the only ones. Is there any chance of reliving the 70s? With the current trend of sitcom casts reuniting, or of old shows being given a new lease on life, many fans wondered if the stars of That 70s Show would ever consider a reunion. Thankfully, it seems that they are all on board for something like that. But there's a hitch. Scheduling. Since leaving the show, the entire cast has gone on to have successful acting careers. And man, they are busy. Topher actually admitted that he thinks it's rare for the cast of a whole show to have gone on to be so successful. And while he's proud of his colleagues, he has hinted that their success is also the reason that a reunion is unlikely to happen. He added, "I would do a reunion for sure, because that was a very wonderful time for us. But I don't think it will happen. It would be so hard to bring that crew together. Everyone seems really busy, but we'd love to do it. I'd love to do it. I'd be down to do it." Admittedly, that's not the answer we wanted, and we'll secretly never give up hope for a reunion. But in the meantime, it's enough knowing that we can still catch up with Topher on his podcast. As he told Vice, "This podcast I'm working on is exactly what it sounds like. that's me hanging out with my friends and having a fun adventure. So if you want to be friends with Topher, you know what to do. For more info about That 70s Show, be sure to check out our video about what the cast is up to now. Thanks for watching, and until next time, stay awesome.